OK, let's get on with the quiz. Our first round is all about history, a round that encompasses everything that's ever happened ever. It could take a while. In 1936, Edward VIII abdicated from the throne. It was the royal scandal of the century. The only way it could have been worse is if he tried to cover it up by claiming he couldn't sweat. William Wallace led the Scottish resistance in the War of Independence. After his trial, he was stripped naked, dragged through the streets by a horse, hung, cut down while still alive, castrated, disemboweled, had his guts burnt in front of him, then beheaded, quartered, and had his head dipped in tar and stuck on a pike. His final words were, "I get it, you're upset." Right, let's get started. I've got some history questions for you. Question number one. Take a look at these men. They went by the nicknames The Weasel, Napoleon, Chaz, Buster, and Big Jim. But what unites them all? Genuinely think I look a little bit like Big Jim. That's just me with my old hairline. I'm aware that Rob and Roisin might not be able to answer because they're not grasses. OK, next we have a question from Paloma Faith. Over to you, Paloma.
Hi, Jimmy. My new album is called Infinite Things and has songs called Supernatural and Monster, but it's another type of infinite being that I wanted to ask you about, gods and goddesses. The ancient Greeks and Romans had loads of them representing all sorts of things, but can your teams tell me the Greek or Roman names for the following? The ruler of the underworld, the king of the gods, and the goddess of love.
OK, that was Sharon from EastEnders in the 80s.
Hey, Jimmy.
Yeah?
We know all of these answers.
Rob Brydon knows all of these answers.
No, the team.
OT, are you... Sorry,
the
robot.
The two of us together.
I'm the robot, the team.
That's your robot dance.
That is my robot
dance. I thought you would
do
the robot a bit better than that somehow.
No, it's shit dance.
It's a shit dance. Question number three. The Victorians had a wide range of slang. All I want to know is what the following meant. Who would I be talking about if I said mutton shunter? Mutton shunter. What's a mutton shunter? What would I be talking about if I mentioned a bag, a mystery? And what body part would I be talking about if I talked about my sauce box? So what's a mutton shunter, a bag, a mystery, and a sauce box? Of course, it wouldn't be the Big Fat Quiz if we didn't have an appearance from the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School performing one of their unconventional school plays. Take a look.
Oh, no, it's gone! Please, it's been stolen.
Do you know who stole it? No, but we must get it back.
Psst. Who are you?
I want lots of money to get it back.
I've been held to ransom.
No!
What is it, doggy? What do you have there?
Woof, woof!
You found it?
He's such a good doggy.
You're a clever doggy.
He's a good boy.
Woof, woof!
The case is closed! Yeah!
I tell you what's weird. We've been doing the Big Fat Quiz of the Year for about 15 years. Those kids haven't got any older. OK, so they were clearly acting out the theft and recovery of the World Cup in 1966.
Oh, I thought that was not the question.
No, the question is, what was the name of the dog that found the World Cup?
No.
Did she say?
No, she didn't say. It's a really famous dog.
In other news, I've come up with another name that I think is more in keeping. What I haven't told OT. Self Mabuse. Self-abuse. Self-Mabuse.
Self-Mabuse.
OK, forget it. I just thought it was a little more edgy. I thought it might be...
So, what was the name of the dog that found the World Cup in 1966?
Sugar Tits.
Stop calling me Sugar Tits and try and get the answer.
I'm going to call you Good Boy. Good Boy. The dog's called Sugar Tits.
Roche, stop it. Take a look at this clip of Edith Russell, an American journalist, speaking in 1970. All I want to know is, what is she talking about?
There was a very slight bump. Just a little jar, nothing at all. And I went in my room. There was a second light jar, nothing of consequence. But you knew something had happened. I don't doubt that they were playing music. Other people heard it. I said, jump, with this thing I've got on. What do you think I am, an acrobat or a monkey or something? We picked up the bits of ice, and most of us played snowballs.
So that was Katherine Ryan there without makeup. But what was she talking about? That was in 1970. What was she talking about? You got this, OT?
I think we do.
Oh, we got this. We're
you got
all
this.
Over this.
It's Team Robot for a reason. We're ready.
Team Robot.
It's a game.
OK, right, time for our first set of answers. Question number one. I showed you the pictures. I said, what connected the Weasel, Napoleon, Chaz, Buster and Big Jim? What did you all put?
I knew that it was a crime, and then Nish elaborated with the Great Train Robbery.
Great Train Robbery is the right answer.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
They did the Great Train Robbery. What did you put? Rob, OT?
Buster, yes.
Yes.
We put white-collar criminals, which is technically true if you look at the photograph.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you're not getting that, yeah. Because they've got... I mean, they're not white-collar criminals.
Well, Jimmy, let's be pedantic, please.
Do you want to have a little look at what the general public thought of the Great Train Robbers?
Yes.
Take a look at this, when they were on the run.
In an escape like this, whose side are you instinctively on, the escaped man or the police?
On the escaped man, I think. I'd like to encourage the police, but I think the escape... I'd like him to have a good run for his money.
I think if I saw him in the street, I should be very tempted to go to the police straight away, because that would give me a chance of personal glory.
I think it's dreadful. I think thieves ought to get what's coming to them. Besides, I'm a policeman's wife.
Paloma Faith asked you to name two gods and a goddess. The Greek or Roman names would be fine. What have you got?
This is quite easy, if you don't mind me saying.
OK, Rob, what do you get?
What do we think, OT?
We said Hades, Zeus
and Venus.
Yeah, it was quite easy.
It was really,
You're going to fist bump like you're in prison. OK.
Katherine Ryan, Katherine. Let me tell you, smash this out at such speed, I'm beginning to think she is an ancient Greek. It was unbelievable.
She's been around a while. She's certainly older than you think, but maybe not ancient Greek. And Rob and Roisin, you've written Sugar Babes. You don't get any points for that. I can only apologise. OK, all right, so third question. I asked you for Victorian slang. OK, so I asked you, what was a mutton shunter? What do you think, Rob? OT?
I think we put shepherd for that.
Oh,
I mean,
that's a good idea.
It's a good answer.
Yeah. I don't think
Is it a right answer?
No.
Well, no. There's another word. Good,
shunter.
Is it?
Did you get mutton shunter?
I thought it was Victorian.
Sheep shagger.
Sheep shagger.
It's another good answer.
It's basically the same as a shepherd, though, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
Well, specific differences.
Differences.
Why would you keep that many?
There's a bunch of people who admit to shagging sheep. And I have a friend who did a travel show, and you speak to them, and they're very happily, like, who in the room has shagged sheep? They put their hands up.
Wow.
It's what they do, and, like...
I'd go flamingo over sheep.
Yeah,
that's fine. It's the sexiest animal.
Yeah.
Flamingo?
What? Flamingos are sexy, aren't
they? Sexy?
I don't want to. It's not like on a Tinder, like, criteria.
I just think it'd be a bit unsteady on one foot. I think you'd lose purchase.
The
danger. Yeah.
They smell. Flamingos smell.
Do they?
Do you like that?
I'll give it a wash first.
We're just taking a brief break while we discuss what animal we would pick. We'll be right back after these messages.
You asked our answer.
Sorry, what's your answer?
We have no idea.
OK.
Perineum.
Oh!
Perineum, you put.
Yes.
OK. So, Victorian slang words. So, a mutton shunter was a policeman because part of their job was to move along prostitutes who were known as muttons. Bag of mystery?
Hot dog.
Oh, just... very close. I think I will give you a point for that.
Oh, what? Really?
What did you get?
I put my pants.
As a bag of mystery.
Just a humorous sort of take on it, really.
I'm almost tempted to give you a point for that as well, because the answer is sausages.
Yes!
What will you find in my pants but a sausage?
OK, and the last sauce box is the body part. What was the...
Ball sack.
Put mouth.
Ooh.
Mouth is the right answer.
Ooh.
OK. Mitchell Brook Primary School performed a school play where they recovered the World Cup in 1966, which was stolen, held to ransom. What was the name of the dog that found it?
Now, if this is correct, I'll be delighted. But I've taken a swing at Brian Dogmeister.
What did you put for this?
I think we put Bobby.
Aww. Just because it's a cute name for a dog.
And it's a
very
difficult question.
You're not wrong. It's a cute name for a dog.
Bobby.
Can we have a go?
Go on, then. What did you get?
Pickles.
Is the right answer.
Thank you.
OK, you saw an American journalist, Edith Russell, recalling a moment from history. What was she describing? I'm going to go over to Roisin and Rob for their answer. What do you think the old lady was talking about?
Strictly Come Dancing.
She was the first winner.
Rob, Otik.
Well, it seemed obviously to be the Titanic striking the iceberg. Our fear in team self-Mabuse slash Roboti is, Oti, is that it's too easy. And maybe it's something a bit more fiendishly clever.
You're right.
But I'm right that it's too easy and it's something more fiendishly clever.
Yeah, no, you're right.
I was halfway answer. Towards doing that, then.
It's a right answer, Titanic. Yay!
Yay.
I think we got slightly distracted.
What did you think it was?
We put Meteor Smash, brackets, aliens, question mark.
Well, I'm going to say no. No, on both of those. I mean, when I've already said the answer, it's the fact there was a bit of hopeful in your voice there. So at the end of that first round, the scores are Rob and Oti have 5, Nish and Katherine have 5, Rob and Roisin, very lucky to have 2.
My girlfriend said she wanted me to tease her. I said, all right, fatty,